I did a video a while back which was about saddle stitching, which is something that I put off for a long time, and then people kept asking me, please do a video about stitching, so I did one. One of the questions that people keep sending me is they're saying that they've watched the video, they've watched Nigel's video about saddle stitching, and they're managing to do the saddle stitching, but they've got this problem whereby they can kind of get it looking sort of zigzaggy on the one side, but it doesn't look as good on the other side. And there's a couple of different ways that you can do the stitching. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to quickly show you a different way today, just a slightly different order to what I did in the video, which might help you do that. One other thing while I'm doing this quick video, I know I haven't done any of the build-along videos for a couple of months now. People keep sending me these messages like, why haven't you done any videos? When's the next video coming out? Are you dead? Stuff like this. No, I'm not a full-time leather worker. It's a business that I do separately. I'm self-employed, but my normal job, which I do, has been absolutely horrific for the last few months. We've been doing some huge projects, and they've not gone all that well, shall we say, and I've been very, very kind of stressed and tired, and I really haven't had time to fit in the videos, so there will be some coming up when things calm down a bit, but it's not something I've been able to commit the time to. I don't think I've given up on them, it's just a patience thing. I'm never going to be one of these YouTube people who wax things out every week. When one pops up on your feed, it'll be a nice little surprise for you. So we'll have a quick look at this now, and hopefully this might help some people. Okay, so what I've got here is I've stuck two pieces of leather together. They should come to about 7-ish mil, yeah, something like that. So like two bits of 3.5 mil leather. So what we're going to do is we're going to call this bit the front and this bit the back. So I'm going to mark a stitching line down there like we normally would do, and then we're going to stitch these together. So because this is only a quick video, I'm not going to go back over all the tools and stuff, I'm just going to basically tell you what they are. So this is one of the Seiwer Japanese pricking irons. All this is covered in the other video, and these are what I've been using ever since I got these now. So with pricking irons, you can either mark a line like this, and then you can go through with an awl or whatever you want to do. The way that I use these now is because they're designed to be used like this, is I basically hammer it all the way through wherever possible. So on a thing like this where it's two pieces, there's nothing to stop me basically going all the way straight through. So all you need to do is make sure that it's lined up vertically, and you can just hammer it right through, making sure that you've gone far enough through that the prongs come out of the other side. And this is how I do almost everything, apart from things that are too thick. So what that's done is that's created a series of diamond holes on the front and the back. Now, when you're doing your stitching, the way I'm doing it is you want the front of the piece on your right hand side. This is all assuming you're right handed. If you're left handed, you should reverse everything or just do it right handed because you're using two needles anyway. So this is the front. These are the diamond holes. The diamond holes are basically orientated from bottom left to top right, this way as you're looking. So as you sit and put this in your pony, and this is the front, those holes are basically pointing down towards your body. So I'm sat now and I've tried to set this camera up so that you can kind of see what I'm looking at. It's a little bit awkward. So this is now clamped in the pony, and this is the front here on my right hand side, this is the back on my left hand side, and these holes, as I say, are orientated so that they're pointing, basically the bottom of the hole is pointing down towards my stomach, the tops of the holes is pointing up and away that way towards the window. Okay, so you've got your first hole, it makes no difference which side you're going from your first hole, so we just go through, center up your thread so that you're starting from the middle. Okay, now some of this will be slightly different to what I did in the video. As I say, there's different ways of doing it. I chop and change things all the time, which is why I don't always like putting things on video, because I might just change it the week after, but it's from that point in time. So what you want to do is, this is what I'm doing, I'm not telling you have to do this is what I'm doing. Okay, so I put the front needle in through the hole just to help open the hole up, especially if it's something thick. Pull that needle out and then put the back needle through, so your back needle, it's your left hand needle, is going in first. So we put that through, take the right hand needle, we come underneath this needle, pinch it and pull it through. And the first one can be difficult because it squashes this down. So we pull that through. What I then do is I lift this up slightly, turn over, and I put this needle in the bottom of the hole, and as I come through to the back, I'm then pulling this back thread through. And what we do then is we've got a loop on the back side here, okay? That loop, we come down like this and we lift it up so that we basically come down, the needle's in the middle of the loop, and then we lift it up so that the needle is going through the loop. Okay, see that? So here the needle comes out, the loops, it's not going through the loop. Drop the loop down, lift the loop up that way so that the needle is coming through. Then we're pulling it through that loop. We pull tight, and then as we pull, this front side here, which is my right hand, I'm pulling a little bit down. This left hand side, which is the back, I'm pulling a little bit up. Okay, so not too much, but it's maybe sort of, you know, 20-30 degrees either way, like that. Okay, and again, so open from the front, needling from the back, come underneath, pull through, lift this out of the way, twist, come in the bottom of the hole, as you come, pull to make sure you've not pierced your thread, drop the loop down and up, pull through, pull a little bit up and down, okay, in from the front, in from the back, come up underneath, make the cross, pull through, pull it up out of the way, into the bottom of the hole, pull through, make sure you've not pierced it, drop your loop down and up, pull through the loop, pull a little bit up and down. Okay, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to twist around the opposite way so you can hopefully see what's going on the back bit. Okay, so you're now looking at this here, this is my left hand side and this is the back of the piece. Okay, so if I put that in there, you can see that's the front needle coming through, back needle through the hole, make the cross, pull through, lift it out of the way, bottom of the hole, pull through so we haven't pierced it, I'm dropping my loop down, up over the needle, pulling the needle through, pulling up tight, front needle through, back needle underneath, pull through, lift it out of the way, bottom of the hole, pulling through, haven't pierced it, dropping the loop down, lifting the loop up, and through. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to carry on doing a few of these just so you can watch the sort of normal speed and the motion of it. Now I wouldn't say that I'm the fastest person at stitching. I do sort of 5 or 6 a minute, which isn't a record or anything, but it's the end results that matter. It doesn't matter how long it takes you to do it really, as long as it looks nice and correct when you've done it. So every single time this is exactly the same, there's no variation or anything like that, it's basically the same stitch just over and over again. And once again, there's all different ways of doing this, so I'm not saying this is the correct way. All I'm saying is I'm going to show you this result in a minute, and if you're happy with what it looks like, it's something you can try and then go from there. Nearly at the end there now. If I haven't explained it well enough, just watch it a couple of times
on the video, because I know there's a lot of people from abroad who watch these, and you know, it's a lot easier for them to look and see what's going on rather than trying to listen, because it's sometimes difficult to understand, and I appreciate that, which is why I've just filmed been doing this a few times. Okay, so I'm at the end of this now, so what I'm going to do is take this off and then we'll just have a look at what it looks like. So here we can see the front. Obviously we marked it front, so we know we've not mixed it up. And as you can see, we've got that nice zigzag effect where we're going from the bottom of the hole to the top of the hole on each stitch, and that gives us that nice sort of angled zigzag look. As I say, what people have been saying they're struggling with is they can manage to do this, but then when they flip it over and look at the back, it's kind of straightened down. It looks more like a running stitch. Depending on what you're making, that might or might not matter. For something where you're going to see both sides, like a bag perhaps, or a wallet or something like that, you want it to look nice on both sides. So if we flip this over and look at the back, you can see that we've also got that zigzag effect on the back going from the bottom to the top of the holes. And it's a slightly different look. It doesn't look absolutely identical to the front. I certainly can't make it look identical on both sides, maybe with more practice. But you can see that we have still got the zigzag look. It hasn't straightened out, which is what people were struggling with. And as well, once you've done your stitching, if you hammer it flat, it changes again slightly. So if we take the cobbler's hammer, flatten this down, which is what I would normally do. Then again, that will flatten out the appearance slightly as well on both sides. But hopefully that's going to help you. As I say, there's all different ways of doing this, but if you want to use this as a starting point, you can do. Lots of people change the way they stitch from time to time if they find a better way, and it really doesn't take that long sort of for the muscle memory to kick in and for you to learn a new habit or a new way of doing something. Okay, so new build along videos coming up soon, and by soon I mean sometime before Christmas, not next week. So, you know, stay tuned, and I'll see you next time.